Hi, and welcome to Monuments of Modulation, Volume 1. Bernadette by the Four Tops. This is a song written by the Holland Dozier Holland team that wrote a lot of Motown hits. And they do a lot of what I want to talk about today, which is this great modulation that happens in this song. It actually happens a few times, but I'm going to zero in on just one of those times. And the time I'm talking about is about, it's after the second chorus or so, about a minute and a half into the song, and it's this part. So let's listen up to there and figure out what's happening. Start with the bass line. So this song is in the key of E flat. In fact, tangent, this song is a great example of something we call modal mixture. It's in the key of E flat. Pairs E and. Wait. Really, I want to talk about the bass line. So it's in the key of E-flat, that's what I just said. And we got this bass line that basically centers around an E-flat, and then a D-flat, and then a C-flat. Sorry people who don't know this, but yeah, there's C-flats. It sucks, because you like to think that a C-flat is just a B, but it's not. This is a good example of when it's not, because it's going to a B-flat. So it can't be a B. That would be weird. In fact, most of these notes aren't from E-flat, they're from E-flat minor. And so this is a great example of something we call modal mixture. I'll talk about it one day. In the key of E-flat, though, we got this one chord. That's our tonic chord. We got this flat big 7 chord. We got this flat big 6 chord. And we got a 5 chord. These two chords are the chords that they would be if we were in E-flat minor. The 5 chord and the 5 chord would be the same no matter what. So the 1 chord in this progression sounds like it's in E-flat major. Everything else is acting as though we're in minor. It's kind of a nice preview for when this crazy modulation happens. So check it out. So here's that flat 6, 5 chord, more or less. 1 chord, 7 chord, 6 chord. And then holds out this 5 chord. And the top note up there is this, it's a B flat up top. And what happens here is we have a B flat chord, right? If you don't know your Roman numerals, these are these chords basically. There's some different stuff that happens in there, I'm just kind of ignoring it. E flat, D flat, C flat, B flat. Now, what happens next? Let's go back. Okay. So these things kind of hang over, right? And then the very first note of the next whole section, the same B flat is the first note that gets sung. But let's listen to what happens with the chords and with the bass line. So. Back again. And then it holds over. So that's that same note that holds over. But here's the wild thing. Now all of a sudden, the chord that B flat is in is a G flat chord. There's no G flat chord anywhere in this key. And basically we start this whole little progression that's in the key of G flat. We have a G flat I'll write it right here, a G flat chord. And then, in your heart, then a B flat, no, a C flat, wow, a C flat major 7 chord. And it still has this B natural, no, B flat. Yeah, it still has this B flat up here. Basically though, this is what I want to talk about. This great modulation. In the key of E flat, right? The normal 3 chord in the key of E flat. In fact, all the normal chords in E flat. You'd have an E flat chord. You'd have an F minor chord, a G minor chord, an A flat chord, a B flat chord, a C minor chord, a D diminished chord, and back to E flat. In E flat minor, you'd have an E flat minor chord. You'd have an F diminished chord. You'd have a G flat major chord, A flat minor chord, B flat minor, but we usually turn it to major. Here's your C flat chord. Here's your D flat chord. A lot of times you'll have a D diminished chord in there instead, and an E flat. So what we did is we were in the key of E flat, right? But we had already been using our 6 and 7 chords, flat 6 and flat 7 chords from minor. And now we modulated to the 3 chord from minor. So we call this a chromatic median modulation. And the way he does it is through something we call a common tone modulation. So I'll write those both down. So when we talk about chromatic median moves, median means moving by third. In traditional classical music, there's a lot of median modulation. A lot of times a piece in a minor key will modulate to its relative major. That's a super common kind. But it's usually moving by third in the key. So like if I was in the key of E flat minor, it would be normal to go to G flat. If I was in E flat major and I was gonna go a third, maybe I'd go to G minor or go down a third to C minor. Chromatic means we're using a move of a third not in the key. So from E flat to G flat is a chromatic median move up a minor third. When we're in a major scale in the normal modulation by a third, going up would be major. These can sound really jarring unless you have a way to smooth them over, and that is exactly what the common tone modulation here does. Modulation means change of keys. And there's lots of different ways to change keys, some more gradual and smooth, some more sudden and jarring. And this common tone one is kind of in between. It would be a very jarring move to suddenly go from E flat to G flat. But what we've done, what Hozier, Dozier, Holland, and Dozier? I always forget. There's at least one of each. Oh, it's Holland, Dozier, and Holland. Okay, cool. Holland, Dozier, and Holland held onto this B flat. And then the B flat is scale degree 5 in the key of E flat. It's a sol. We call that sol in solfege. But then all of a sudden, that same note that gets held over or repeated is scale degree 3. It's a mi in the key of G flat. So even though it's the same note, right? It's a B flat. This is like one of the most important things in music theory is just being a note doesn't tell you all you need to know about a note. It's what a note is doing, and it's how a note fits in the scale you're in. And so what is accomplished by this modulation is with no preparation, no kind of warning, no getting you ready for it, all of a sudden you have to reinterpret this note, this B flat, as part of a G flat chord. Let's hear it a few more times. So here we are, E flat. totally comfortably in the key of E flat. Here's this held chord. Cool, right? Well, there's something super even cooler about it that I don't know if it was on purpose or not, but this blew my mind when I noticed this. Maybe it will blow your mind. Listen to the lyrics here. If we listen to the lyrics, right, let's go back and listen again. Levi Stubbs is the singer, and Levi Stubbs, right before this modulation, it says, "Bernadette, you're the soul of me." Pretty wild, right? He's like, "You're the soul of me." And he's holding out that note that was soul when he sings it. And then the backup singers, which is this group called the Andantes, hold out this chord. And then Levi Stubbs comes back in on the same note. He doesn't suddenly say me there, but he had said the soul of me. Is it on purpose? I don't know. Is it just a wild coincidence? I don't know. But what it definitely does is it gets us right to the heart of what common tone modulation is all about. Basically, in a common tone modulation, you have a tone. You have a note that has one roll and one key. So in our case, the tone was a B flat. And a B flat is a sol, scale degree 5 in the key of E flat. But that same B-flat is a mi in the key of G-flat, which is the key we are switching to or modulating to. And in a common tone modulation, that is the connection between these two very foreign keys, and it gives this really cool sound. A lot of times there's some really cool voice leading. I just want to show you it on a keyboard here. So talking about the voice leading when we have common tone modulation, this particular common tone modulation, we're going from this B flat type chord. Let me get a cooler sound here. Playing a B flat down here. So we're going from this E flat. Right? E flat major, D flat, C flat. It looks just like B. B flat major. And right now that B flat major sounds like the Roman numeral 5 chord in the key of E flat. This B flat at the top of it sounds like a sol, right? Held up by the singers, and all of a sudden, in your heart I find. So here's like how the voice leading is so neat. Our bass note just goes B flat to G, but there's some upper voice stuff that's cool, inner voices. Both of these inner voices move by half step, like that, and it's this, I don't know, there's something really pleasurable about that, right? And there's something that Holland Dozier and Holland loved about it. There's a lot of songs that do these kind of moves. Two that pop right into my head are Honeybee by the Supremes and Your Precious Love by Marvin Gaye has a similar modulation. Common tone modulation, up a minor third from a major key to a major key, a minor third above. Chromatic median modulation, monument of modulation. Bernadette, thank you very much. Goodbye.